Hey, everyone, and welcome back to Technically You. Are you ready for another podcast? Well, we hope you are. Today, we're wading back into the waters of cybersecurity. But hold on, we're not talking about your typical firewalls, malware, ransomware, and hacking.
Oh, no, we're not.
We're going to investigate the psychological side of cybersecurity.
Psychology. Sounds interesting.
Yes, it is. We are covering the world of social engineering.
Oh, sneaky.
Exactly. And to guide us, we're going to reference a fantastic document we found titled Understanding Social Engineering Attacks and How to Stay Safe.
Sounds intriguing.
It is. Get this. Did you know that hackers can actually manipulate you using psychology? It's more effective than any computer virus out there. Crazy, right?
Yes, it's true. Social engineering is all about human behavior.
So it's not about finding a technical weakness in a system or device?
No, not at all. It is about preying on us.
Us?
Yeah, us, humans.
So basically anyone could be a target.
Exactly. And that is what makes it so dangerous.
Okay, well, the document we're referring calls it the art of manipulation.
It really is manipulation. I mean, we're talking about deception using psychological tricks to get people to spill the beans or do something they shouldn't do.
Spill the beans?
You know, reveal confidential stuff, passwords, bank details, sensitive information, even granting access to a whole system.
So are they basically hacking humans?
Pretty much, I guess.
Humans, not computers. Yeah.
Absolutely. And most times humans are easier to break.
Wow. Okay, well, the document lists a bunch of, I guess I'll say, human hacking techniques. These, what do they call them? Social engineers.
Yeah, they're social engineers, I guess.
Well, let's start with the most successful one, phishing.
Ah, phishing. One of the most common scams. It's those fake emails or text messages.
Oh, yeah.
Made to look like they're from your bank, your boss, a friend, or a social media site. They're designed to trick you. Mostly to get you to click a bad link or give up your personal information.
Like when you get that verify your account email.
Exactly.
And you just casually provide the information, or if it sounds urgent, you panic and click the link or attachment.
Yeah, that sense of urgency, that fear, that's what they want. They're playing you.
Wow. And then there's spearphishing, which is even more targeted.
Yeah, spearphishing. That's like using a sniper rifle and not a shotgun.
Absolutely.
Scammers aren't blasting out tons of messages. These attackers, they do their homework.
What do you mean?
They find out about you from social media, company websites, fake surveys, or whatever else they can find online.
Really?
Oh, yeah. And then they use that information to create a super personalized email.
Personalized? So like what? What would that look like?
Imagine you getting an email that seems to be from your CEO asking for an urgent transfer to funds.
Oh, if I worked in the accounts payable department, I can see myself totally falling for that.
See, that's how good they are.
So how do you protect yourself?
You got to be really careful. Double check the sender's email address every time.
Even if the name looks right?
Especially if the name looks right.
Okay, tell me more.
And if anything feels off, you know, too urgent, sent after hours or during the weekends coming from a new email address, or the message contains spelling errors, verify it. Buy it calling the sender. Don't just take their word for it.
That is good advice. Okay, now what is this? The document mentions pretexting. That sounds like something straight out of a spy movie.
It does, doesn't it? Pretexting. It's all about making up a good story.
A good story in order to gain someone's trust.
Exactly.
Like what? Do they call you up pretending to be IT support or the help desk?
Oh, that's a classic one. They say they need your login to fix a problem and you just...
Let's give it to them.
Hopefully not.
Oh, of course I wouldn't.
But some people do.
Ouch. Okay, so we've got phishing, spear phishing, and pretexting. What other techniques do they use?
Well, there's baiting. This one plays on our weakness for freebies. You know, the free stuff. Who doesn't like something free, right?
Yeah, who doesn't?
Exactly. So picture this. You find a USB drive just lying there in the break room, labeled, let's say, bonus information or employee raises.
Ooh, tempting.
Right? You plug that thing in and boom, malware city.
Okay, I get it. if something seems too good to be true, it probably is, right? And by the way, who would leave such valuable information out in the open? Okay, there is also a section on tailgating. I feel like I may have accidentally done that one before.
So tailgating is when you exploit physical security, slipping through a door behind someone.
Oh, okay.
Or, you know, pretending to be a delivery person or a maintenance guy to get into a restricted area.
That's sneaky.
It is. We're often so polite with holding doors open.
Right. It's human nature.
Yes. And we forget about the risks.
Yeah, that's true. And finally, there's quid pro quo. That's the one where you exchange favors, right?
Bingo. I will do something for you. You give me information. And one of the classic examples is fake tech support.
Oh, when they offer to help you, but they need your password or credentials.
Exactly. It's amazing how creative they get.
It is. It is. But why do we fall for this stuff? What makes us so vulnerable?
Well, it's all about how our brains work. They prey on our emotions, our fears, our curiosity, and our need to be helpful. We're trusting and we like shortcuts, especially when we're stressed or busy.
So it's not just about being gullible?
No, not at all.
It's about understanding how our own minds work against us.
Exactly.
Okay, so what can we do? How do we protect ourselves?
Well, the document we're looking at, it gives some great advice.
Let's hear it.
First up, verify.
Verify?
Yeah, verify everything. Any requests for sensitive information, double check it.
Even if it seems legit.
Especially if it seems legit. Make a phone call or send a separate direct email to the organization to make sure it's real.
So don't just take their word for it.
Nope, nope, and nope.
Okay, good advice. What about links? You know, those tempting links and downloads.
Ah, yes. Be skeptical.
How skeptical?
Don't click anything from a source you don't recognize. Hover over links before you click on them. Especially if it was unsolicited.
Yes, check the actual URL.
Exactly. And if anything looks even a little bit suspicious, don't click it. Report the deceptive email to your IT department and delete it.
So a little paranoia is a good thing in this digital world?
Absolutely.
Okay, what else? What else can we do?
Use multi-factor authentication.
Oh, MFA. Yeah, I use it every day. Can you explain it to our listeners?
Okay, it's like an extra lock on your door. You need more than just your password to get in.
Yeah, like a code from your phone.
Right, or an app notification. It makes it way harder for hackers to get in, even if they somehow have your password.
Okay, that makes sense. What else?
Be careful what you share online. Less is more. I preach this to my family all the time.
Oh, so the scammers can't use our information against us.
Exactly. Go through your social media privacy settings and make sure they are on. And remember to always think before you post. Some personal information like events, travel, promotions, titles, they can be used against you.
Good point. So we know about their tactics, and we're now taking steps to protect ourselves. Are we good? Are we safe yet?
Well, it's a good start, but you got to stay informed.
Informed?
The bad guys are always coming up with new tricks and tools.
So we got to keep learning.
Exactly. Read articles, listen to podcasts. Like the one we're doing now.
Oh, I love doing these podcasts. We get to share valuable information with our listeners to inform and educate them about cybersecurity threats and what is going on in the ever-evolving world of technology.
Yes, knowledge is powerful.
So true. The document also mentions something about security policies.
Ooh, yes, especially for organizations. Security policies are key, like using strong passwords, encryption, and having incident response plans. It's about building a culture of security where everyone's responsible.
Okay, so to sum it all up, technology's great, but
it's not enough.
We need to be aware of the
psychology behind these attacks, and we need to be proactive, not reactive.
So as you go about your day today, I want you to think about this. Knowing what you know now about social engineering, what's one thing you'll do differently online to protect yourself?
It could be something small like enabling MFA, being careful about sharing personal information on social media, calling before clicking, or something bigger like starting a conversation about security at work.
Every little thing we do helps.
Absolutely.
Well, that's about it for today's podcast. So as always, stay safe and stay curious, and we'll catch you next time.
See ya.